I stood here, March 7th, 1965, prior to walking up to that bridge to be beaten by law enforcement officers. Most of the marchers, you know so much about, left from right here.
And I'm saying that this is an unlawful assembly. You have to disperse. You are ordered to disperse. Go home or go to your church. This march will not continue.
Trooper said there will be no march between Selma and Montgomery. You have 3 minutes to go back to your church. In 1 minute and 15 seconds, they attacked.
We must remain true to nonviolence. I'm asking everybody in the line. If you can't be nonviolent, don't get in it. You can't accept blows without retaliating. Don't get in the line. You can accept it out of your commitment to nonviolence. You will somehow do something for this nation that may well save it.
The long-anticipated Freedom March from Selma to Alabama's capital of Montgomery finally gets underway as Dr. Martin Luther King addresses the crowd at the starting point. Twice before, the marchers had been turned back by state troopers. Now they march under a federal court order and with the protection of federalized National Guard units and regular troops, a total of nearly 3,000 men. For the first day, there are 3,200 marchers in line. Half of the four-lane Highway 80 is closed to traffic. Later, where it becomes two lanes, the marchers had been ordered by the court to reduce their number to 300, a measure designed for their safety. The demonstration is peaceful. The first day, the marchers tramp a little over 7 miles. Those who have been assigned to complete the 54-mile walk hope to present a petition to Governor George Wallace.
We strike away the last major shackle of those fierce and ancient bonds.
And I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you, but I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land. So I'm happy tonight. I'm not worried about anything. I'm not fearing any man. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord.
Then I'm walking in Memphis. Just walking with my feet 10 feet off a beam. Walking in Memphis, but do I really feel the way I feel?
Some very sad news for all of you, and I think sad news for all of our fellow citizens and people who love peace all over the world. And that is that Martin Luther King was shot and was killed tonight in Memphis, Tennessee.
get off the bus at the Lorraine Hotel, I actually teared up.
We shall overcome. Deep in my heart, I do believe we shall overcome. Though I've joined hands so often with students and others behind jail bars singing it, we shall overcome. Sometimes we've had tears in our eyes when we joined together to sing it, but we still decided to sing it.
So many things go on and it's pushed under the rug. So if you could just stand up and let it be known, that would make things happen or make a change.
Think about the next 50 years if we can make progress as you have the last 50 years. And then get up off your behind and do something. Is that clear? Now we see.